Welcome back to Waitangi, where we have been broadcasting all morning, and we're very fortunate to have join us this morning is Labour MP for Tāmaki Makaurau, Peeni Henare. Morena e te rangatira.
Morena, morena.
Thank you for dressing up. Actually, I wasn't sure whether you'd just turn up in your T-shirts or like Scotty Morrison been out for a run this morning.
Oh, well, you know, I always dress up for people like yourself, but also, you know, let's not forget that Waitangi Day is yet to come, so there's still work to be done.
Aye, and there was a lot of work, well, there's a lot of work that's been done throughout the week. But I'd like to specifically talk to you about the pōwhiri that happened yesterday, because it was beautiful and very moving, what you spoke to me about before we came on air. So talk us through yesterday here at Waitangi. The political leaders were all welcomed here at Waitangi. So talk us through that experience for you, being from here, but also, you know, arriving here with Labour.
So, you know, I know the focus is always on the parliamentarians that come here. The Prime Minister and her words, I guess her kofo or sermon to the people, if you like. But for me, it was an overwhelming success for Ngāpuhi. Insofar as we felt unified, it was speaking as one voice to the parliament and to government about the issues that affect Ngāpuhi and indeed wider Māoridom. So, you know, I was overjoyed by the fact that Ngāpuhi were singing from the same song sheet in such a critical time where we're yet to settle. We have a number of issues up here. And it was important that parliament as a whole, not just the government, but parliament as a whole, get to hear exactly what those issues are and how we might be able to solve them.
Yesterday there was also a little bit of an issue in terms of Judith Collins not feeling like she'd been afforded the opportunity to speak on the Maho, Jacinda Ardern, our Prime Minister. What are your thoughts on that?
Look, it's clear that Jacinda is our Prime Minister. She's been afforded that opportunity to speak here, as I said, to give her kofo to our people. But from a Ngāpuhi perspective, as a person who sits on the Ngāpuhi taumata, it isn't as simple as just offering her the opportunity to speak. There are processes for us to go through. If Ms. Collins wants the opportunity to speak, perhaps she should have led the National Party onto the lower marae.
Today there is the Iwi Chairs Forum, which we already know is going to be done differently. Prime Minister is travelling to Whangarei, where it will be done virtually. How important is it for the government to listen to Iwi leaders?
Look, it's super important, and we know that Iwi have continually come to the table to talk about what the solutions are to the issues. We know in the broad context housing is an issue. However, Iwi have these very bespoke ways of being able to deal with them. They own whenua, they have capacity. So it's important that we are able to sit down with them and talk through what those issues are and how we support them. I know they come with a number of issues. I mentioned housing, but you know, I know water and infrastructure and other things into the future are really important. So we'll be all ears, and we'll be coming with some of the kaupapa that the government want to progress, and I'm sure that it'll be a fruitful conversation.
One way of putting it. I want to talk to you, and I want to talk to you on a personal note, because we know that there were the commemorations, the 175th commemorations of Te Rua Peka Peka, which happened on Wednesday. But you and your lovely partner, Skye, went up there on Tuesday. Talk us through why you went up early and what that experience was like.
It's little known that I'm a descendant of both an officer of the 58th Regiment of the Redcoats who were the British, and I'm also the descendant of the ancestor Te Aho and Kawiti on the inside of the pā. So I've got skin in the game on both sides, and that evening it was nice to get up there and really soak it all in, soak in the atmosphere, try and consider what they were thinking and what was going through their minds at the time before we actually move on to the commemoration the following day. Because the commemoration was He Rua Whakautu Mō Te Riri, or a place of remembrance and reverence and where we can remember those who passed. But it's also, I guess, a line in the sand to say let's move on into the future. And both Kawiti and the Prime Minister used the words Titiro ki ngā taumata o te moana, look to the horizon, because it's only there we'll find our opportunities in the future. So over 48 hours, it was pretty special.
Yeah. Talk to us about how special Waitangi Day is here as well. I mean, there's different things that happen. There's political things going on over this week leading up to the actual day, the 6th of February. What's it like here?
Waitangi is special, and it's fair to say I'm biased because of my family whakapapa here. But it is special, the weather, the people, the conversations, the protest even, you know, I think, a fair reflection of much of Aotearoa New Zealand. It's not simply just, you know, conversations between Ngāpuhi and the Crown. You'll see ethnicities, diversity. You'll see a number of kaupapa come to this marae and be presented for us all to consider. So it's special, and I encourage anyone to come up here. It's beautiful.
Yeah, well, and actually, why would you encourage people to come here? Because there might be people who are scared to come up here, scared of the unknown, right? Mm. So tell us why you would encourage people to come.
Well, we've made an effort as a trustee here in Waitangi and also a government member and also a local to make sure that this place is accessible and it's welcoming to everybody. We've done a number of things over the past few years to make it more inclusive. So, you know, I'd encourage people to come up here, experience the hospitality, the warm nature of everything that happens here. So, you know, if not for any other reason, the weather's fantastic.
True story. And just as we wrap things up, it was announced yesterday that Matariki would become a public holiday. I mean, this is a wonderful celebration and acknowledgement of Māori mā tauranga or Māori knowledge.
Most definitely, and it's being acknowledged worldwide that we're taking a different approach. The Gregorian calendar was and has served the world for so long, and now we're taking opportunity to express ourselves and our national identity in Matariki. While we acknowledge it as the Māori New Year, I think it can be something quite special for the entire country to bring everybody onto this kaupapa, to share the knowledge of our ancestors that navigated here, and make sure that we can set the path right for the new year to come.
Nice. What will you be doing tomorrow? How will you celebrate?
Tomorrow I will be visiting cemeteries locally, because a number of our ancestors who made this what it is today, for example, my grandfather, the longest serving trust member here, my great-grandfather, the first serving trust member here, my father, so I'll be visiting them.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for your time this morning, for your kōrero, for your insights, and yeah, for your personal insights. I really appreciate that. Tēnā koe.
Tēnā koe, and tell Scotty to do some work.
You can tell Scotty that. Peeni Henare, tēnā koe. Thank you. Back to you guys in the studio.
Jamie, can you ask the Minister, please, just to have a conversation with our friend Mark Watty, make sure there's a couple of crayfish on the way back to Tāmaki Makaurau when he's finished in Te Tai Taukarau. Thanks.
Scotty wants to make sure that there's a couple of kōrau on the way back to Tāmaki Makaurau.
I've got some of those for you, my friend, but there's also some kina with your name on it too.
And you can have all of those kina.
It's a real Pākehā test, the kina, isn't it? I know what you're playing at, Minister. Thank you, J-May. Thank you, Minister Henare. Appreciate your time.